Welcome to NG Classes YouTube channel. In this video, we'll consider the concept of finding inverse DFT. So that I call it as the IDFT of the sequence x of k is equal to 2 comma 1 plus j 0 1 minus j. The task is they have given x of k. We need to find x of n, and we know that x of n is nothing but IDFT. That is inverse DFT of x of k. So how do I find that? For this I have already the formula. X of n is equal to 1 divided by n. So this is the formula, summation k equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of k w n to the power minus k into n. So this is the formula to find IDFT of any sequence. So now x of k is given. I need to put it over here, expand the limit, later find x of n. Before that, I should know what are my twiddle factors. So here the twiddle factors: w4 to the power 0 is equal to 1, w4 to the power 1 is equal to minus j, w4 to the power 2 is equal to minus 1, and lastly w4 to the power 3 is equal to plus j. So this thing we already have. So next the task is to find, but giving looking at the given formula, looking at this formula, twiddle factor take the negative form. Getting it? To find w4 to the power minus 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 is important for me. To write that, I know the result. Wn to the power minus n is equal to wn to the power n star. So this star indicates the complex conjugate. So how do I write that? If there is any imaginary part, change the sign of that. And if there is real part, just keep it as it is. So using that result, I could write w4 to the power minus 0. So this still remains same. So there is no change. W4 to the power minus 1. So w4 to the power 1 was minus j. So now it becomes, its complex conjugate becomes plus j. So this is important. Next I have a w4 to the power minus 2. W4 to the power 2 was minus 1. W4 to the power minus 2. Does it become plus 1? No, it doesn't. As it does not have any imaginary part, real part, we just have to keep it as it is. And lastly, W4 to the power minus 3. So earlier it was J. Now it becomes minus J. So this will be its complex conjugate. So now we are ready. So we can solve for X of N. So I'll just consider the formula again. X of n is equal to 1 by capital N, 1 by 4 it is, because it is 4 point DFT. There are 4 samples, so n must be 4. So just put everything. Summation k equal to 0 to n minus 1, that is 3. X of k, I'll just put it as it is for time being. X of k w4 to the power minus k into n. Getting it? So this is what the given formula becomes. So now I can expand this formula by varying k. So I'll just let 1 by 4 as it is. So now I'll put k equal to 0. I would get x of 0 w4 to the power 0 plus, I'll put n equal to k equal to 1. So this is not small x, this will be capital X. 1 k equal to 1 w4 to the power k is 1, so it becomes 1 into n, that is minus sign is there, minus n, plus capital X of 2. I'll put n equal to k equal to 2. Now x of 2 w4 to the power k is 2, it is minus 2n. Following it? Okay. And next, the last term, by placing k equal to 3, I'll get x of 3 w4 to the power minus 3n. So this is what I get. So later I'll just put the values for the given x of k. X of 0 is 2. X of 0 is 2. I'll just put it. W4 to the power 0 is 1. 2 into 1 is just 2. Plus x of 1. X of 1 is nothing but 1 plus j. It is given. 1 plus j. W4 to the power minus n. I'll just keep it as it is for time being. Plus x of 2. X of 2 is nothing but it is given as 0. So this is 0. I'll not write it. Lastly, x of 3. What is x of 3? X of 3 is 1 minus j. So I'll write it. 1 minus j. W4 to the power minus 3n. So this is the expression I have got for x of n. So now to find the different samples of x of n, I need to put n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. So first I'll put n equal to 0 so that I'll get my first sample x of 0 equal to. So let's see that 1 by 4, 2 plus w4 to the power 0 is nothing but 1. So I'll get 1 plus j. Correct? Then plus 1 minus j is there. This gets multiplied with w4 to the power 0, which is 1. So this is what I get. So I can see here plus j minus a will cancel with each other. 2 plus 1 plus 1, which is 4, divided by 4, I would get it as 1. So my first sample x of 0 is equal to 1. Getting it? Similarly, now I'll put n equal to 1 so that I can find x of 1 equal to, which is equal to 1 by 4. So I'll consider this formula again, and I'll put the value n equal to 1. 2 plus 1 plus j w4 to the power minus 1. So now what is w4 to the power minus 1? I have just written it as j. So I'll just multiply this with j. Getting it? Similarly, continuing further, I have 1 minus j w4 to the power minus 3. What is w4 to the power minus 3? W4 to the power minus 3 is minus j. So I need to multiply this with minus j and later simplify it further. Let's see what do I get. This is 1 by 4. This is 2 plus j square, and j square is minus 1. So that result is important. So one should know that j square is minus 1. So that's I have written. Then 1 into minus j, it is minus j. Then minus of minus, it becomes plus j square. J square is minus 1 again. So what happens here? Plus j minus j will cancel. Minus 1 and minus 1, it becomes minus 2. Plus 2, it is 0. Getting it? So this is x of 1. So this is how I get x of 1 as a 0. So this is my second sample. Similarly, to get my third sample, I'll put n equal to 2 so that I will get x of 2 equal to. So what will be x of 2? I'll consider the same this formula. In that, I'll put n equal to 2. Let's see that. This is 2 plus 1 plus j w4 to the power minus 2. So what will be w4 to the power minus 2? It is minus 1. Getting it? So I'll multiply this with minus 1. Is that okay? Next, plus 1 minus j w4 to the power minus 3 into 2, it is minus 6. So w4 to the power minus 6, how do I find that? W4 to the power minus 6, there is no way. So only thing is I can make use of the periodic property. This is 0, 1, 2, 3. If there is anything that falls after that, I'll just write it below this. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, something like this. So I was looking for w4 to the power minus 6, which is equal to w4 to the power minus 2, and its value is minus 1. Correct? So I multiply here this with minus 1. So now I'll try to simplify this further. So this is 2 minus 1 minus j minus 1 plus j. Getting it? Minus j and plus j will cancel. Minus 1 minus 1, it is minus 2 plus 2, it becomes 0 again. So x of 2 is also 0. And now I'll go and find the last sample for n equal to 3. So now put n equal to 3, I would get x of 3 equal to. So this is the formula I was looking here. This one. 1 by 4 into bracket 2 plus 1 plus j w4 to the power minus n. N is 3. So I would get w4 to the power minus 3. So what is w4 to the power minus 3? It is minus j. Correct? So I would write minus j. Plus the last term, it is 1 minus j. So I would write 1 minus j w4 to the power minus 3n. N is 3, w4 to the power minus 9 it is. 3 into 3 is 9. So what is the answer for that? Here it is. W4 to the power 9 is W4 to the power 5, which in turn equal to W4 to the power 1. So here I have the result. W4 to the power minus 1 is J. So I would write J here. So what is next? Just try to simplify this further. This is 1 by 4. This is 2 as it is. 1 plus 1 into minus J, it is minus J. Plus J into minus J, it is minus J square. J square is minus 1, minus of minus, it becomes plus 1. And lastly, plus j and minus j square. J square is minus 1, minus of minus, it becomes plus 1. So minus j and plus j would cancel. So this is 2 plus 1 plus 1, which is 4 divided by 4 is equal to 1. So this is my last sample, x of 4 equal to. X of 4 is equal to 1. So I would combine all these samples and finally I would write x of n equal to, this is 1, 0, 0, 1. So that's what I write. Finally, the IDFT of the sequence x of k, which is equal to x of n, which is equal to 1, 0, 0, 1. So this will be my final answer. Hope everyone has understood it. So if there are any doubts, please let me know in the comment section. Thanks for watching.